Perfect. Okay, let's do it. Lights, camera, action. Hi, folks. I'm Captain Dalton. And I'm here to talk to you about just one thing, fish. You know those scaly creatures that go good with tartar sauce and so bad with oxygen? Anyways, you want to greet them, meet them and eat them, and I'm the guy that's going to fix you up. Me and the Maria D. Short on scallops? No bait in your pail? Well, don't you worry none, because Cap Dalton ain't nothing but anything. Cut! Now stop that! Can't you see I'm trying to make a TV commercial here? Now I gotta do it all over again. Hey, pal. How would you like to be on TV? This is gonna be great. Hey, where are you going? Holy mother mackerel. With the salt spray in my face and the wailing wind in my back, I photographed the rare white dolphin as he frolicked in the sea. I had stumbled upon a unique scientific find.
Hey, Whitey, where are you going?
Look, this is no time to be jealous. You're a nice dolphin and all that, but this guy's gonna make me mucho dinero. Cut it out! You're gonna get your blubber butt run over! Hey! Look! He's getting away!
Thank you. escaping them.
Oh, no, everybody. Not the red ring, the gold ring.
Hey, only cut some slack. I'm sure not every female in the vicinity of Palm Beach is into gold rings.
Nor, I'm sure, is every male in the vicinity of Bondi Beach, especially into nose rings.
I never ring in my nose.
Guess I was confused. You just seem like the type and all.
Hey, who are the older, more mature influences here?
Oh, we are. Sorry, Maya.
Likewise. Dean just seems to have a way of...
pushing your buttons?
In your dreams, Outback Boy.
Look, Jennifer, I mean, Dr. Duncan's gonna want to see some results on this retrieval experiment. Okay? Okay. Ready? Okay. Aphrodite, get the gold ring! Go!
You know, this ring experiment is so basic.
Maybe. But it's a very good way of getting two brand new interns introduced to the subject. Also...
what's wrong?
Through the shark gate.
Well, what do we do?
Pull off the spine. All right, Wing, keep her still. Come on, girl, easy. There. That's all of it. Thanks, Wayne. Let her go.
Go ahead.
What's wrong with her? Can't we give her something to calm her down?
How about some decaf? Excuse me, Dr. Dalton, but you're curing her with decaffeinated coffee?
You're expecting cappuccino.
Instant would have worked too, just as long as it was piping hot. Stingray spines have a toxin in them which continue to cause extreme pain even after the toxin's been removed.
It's allergic to coffee.
It's allergic to extreme heat. Now, if the three of you will boil up some water so you can soak Aphrodite's fin and get the rest of the toxin out, I'm sure she'll be very grateful. What's that? Just overgrown boys with their overgrown toys.
Injected, gas-powered, high-pressure cushion, even faster than the specs. And don't get any ideas about ever driving it because of...
Shh, leave me alone. I'm connecting.
Not again.
She is just so amazing. Oh, that was so beautiful I could cry.
What was?
She just poured a thermos of coffee on a dolphin.
Oh, she sounds stranger than you. Anyway, why don't you just forget about it? She's not your type.
Quinn, how do you know what my type is?
She's pretty, has a great job, and therefore too smart to mess around with you. Ergo, not your type.
Give it time.
Hey, man, meter's running. We ought to run a search and rescue on your wallet.
Oh? Why is that?
Because we've been at this substation 3 weeks, 2 days, 6 hours, and 14 minutes, and somehow the Pretty Dolphin Doc has not yet been swept off her feet by Deputy Sheriff Tom Hampton.
So? It'll happen. Now you're trying to lay some statute of limitations thing on me?
The only limitation is your capital. Speaking of which, you presently owe me $17,000 in search and rescue, Deputy Garnett. 25 degrees north, 80 degrees west. We're on our way. Floater.
Breathing?
Pilot who spotted him said there's a dolphin holding him up.
Oh, anyone we know?
Another foul says the floater's some diver from Nebraska.
Nah, this time of day it's probably a fisherman.
Diver.
Fisherman.
Diver.
Fisherman.
I'm telling you, diver.
Double or nothing, you guys are fishermen.
Done.
It's only been 4 weeks since Dr. Ricks and Pam are transferred, but it kind of seems like forever, but a real good forever. Not that I don't miss them, I do. But in a way, I know they're still here with me, and I'm grateful they convinced me to give Dr. Dalton a chance.
I think you can call me Jennifer. It's fewer letters to type than Dr. Dalton.
I wasn't going to give you a chance, because I was. It's just that...
It's just, you've had a lot more tough adjustments to make in the last few months than most 16-year-olds ever have to make.
I'm okay.
I know you are. I was kind of a emancipated minor myself at 16. Just wasn't a legal thing. Don't be afraid to be afraid, Maya.
Of what?
Of giving the transition from girl to grown up some time. Just be a little bit wary of the adult world and you'll be all right. And one more thing.
Do all my homework and brush twice daily.
Yes. And I would save my journal on floppy. Wouldn't want any of my personal stuff on the Institute hard drive.
Oops.
Hey, Doc. How's the wonderful world of fish?
Speaking of being a little bit wary.
Is she dissing me again?
Who, Dr. Dalton? I mean, Jennifer.
Yeah, Dr. J herself. Wary of who? Oh, come on, me? Is it my fault the university regents agreed to put the search and rescue substation at your institute?
Holly, Dean, fish food run. Let's take the cruiser.
Or is the extra funding that you get from the county a big problem?
No, the extra funding I get is a godsend. However, I look at your specific presence as one of those great sacrifices I have to make for science and humankind.
See, everybody wants to tear down a hero. Sign of the times.
There's another sign of the times that perhaps you missed.
Oh, which one is that?
The one at the entrance that says, admittance to faculty and students only.
Nope, didn't miss it. I was merely hoping to ask one of the faculty out to lunch.
I don't think so.
Along with one of the students, of course. I wanted to ask you a couple of questions about Flipper. I thought maybe we could do it over some food at the shipwreck. You know, this hero stuff makes me really hungry. What do you say, Doc?
She says cool.
One hour after my supply run.
Yes.
Nice work. Thanks.
Oh, people are so weird.
Wait till you all get a load of this. The video that's gonna change your lives. Here goes. I was all alone on the high seas, and with the salt spray in my face and the wailing wind in my back, I photographed a great white dolphin as he frolicked in the sea. I realized I had stumbled upon a unique scientific find. Actually, folks, this guy's more than a unique scientific find. He's one of a kind. A dolphin like you've never seen before or ever will again. Which is why you should take my charter and be among the first to see this freak of nature live and in the flesh.
Where'd you say you saw this white dolphin?
Didn't. And I ain't gonna, unless you're a paying customer. Which is why you should take your deposits now, folks. As soon as I get the little problem with the Maria D fixed up, we'll all be going out to find the great white dolphin.
Great. When's that gonna be?
As soon as I get some more deposits.
Party Adventures.
Yeah. No kidding. Pure white? Listen, where are you calling from?
Right outside the Shipwreck Cafe.
Well, how do you know it isn't some kind of like a hoax?
Because I just saw the video. The guy that took it almost got drowned. Hang on a minute.
Lunchtime, Flip.
What's a one-of-a-kind white dolphin worth on the open market?
To the right people, plenty. Listen, buy the Okuda drink. I'll be there as soon as I can.
No problem.
Well, that was some 1 hour. I'm starved.
Live bloodworm. Or yep. Another delectable morsel.
Live bloodworms, Flipper? Beef hearts?
No, I didn't think so.
Okay, can you guys deal with feeding the electric yellows or neon tetras, tank 6 and 7?
Please, Dr. Dalton.
I once had to feed a neighbor's pet cat for a whole week.
Okay. Let's eat.
I mean, it seems as though Flipper's got a sixth sense.
Hey, guys.
Hi.
There you are.
He knows where to be and when to be there. It's almost like having another man on the team.
Except he's a dolphin.
Yeah, and he comes real cheap. But what I wanted to ask you was, that demented fisherman I pulled out of the ocean this morning, he mentioned something about Flipper having a friend, a white dolphin. Do you know what he's talking about?
Mm-mm. Flipper's kind of a rogue.
Come on, folks.
A loner, usually.
Who's next? Who's next? Who wants to be part of scientific history and view the eighth wonder of the sea, the incredible white dolphin? Roll up, roll up. Put your money down and reserve your space now while I still got some left. Ha! Time's running out.
Jennifer, you okay?
That's that demented fisherman I was talking about.
That demented fisherman is my father.
Hey, Jen!
Whoops.
That's my little girl.
Oh, no.
Dr. Jennifer Dalton, the finest little marine biologist in the Keys. Bartender, the drinks are on me.
Is that the pretty girl you're watching?
Figures. Hey, Jen. I bet you you're surprised.
Surprised? No. Just dismayed, deceived, depressed. Hello, Cap.
There is absolutely no such thing as a white dolphin. Admit it.
I could do that, but it'd be a darn lie. I got it all right here. I caught it on tape.
You doctored it.
And when did I do that? While I was drowning?
Oh, you weren't drowning.
I was too. Ask him.
Oh, he was definitely drowning.
Why do you have to be so adequate at your job?
Hey, a compliment.
Better take them when you can.
Would the two of you excuse us for a moment?
No problem.
These sentimental family reunions always choke me up.
Let's see.
All right. Just what are you doing here, Cap?
Well, first, I'm going to try the Mai Tais and see if they're as good as advertised. And then if they are, I'm going to have another, just to be sure. You know how thorough I like to be.
I'm talking about what are you doing here in Bal Harbor?
Where I work, where I live.
It's coincidence, huh, Jen?
Don't call me Jen. You know I hate Jen, and...
Maybe you'd prefer Dr. Dolphin?
I prefer if you stay out of my life, Cap. I thought we had an arrangement.
No. No, we had an estrangement. You're the doc with a title, but I think that word means we don't get along so good. Don't have to be like that, Jen.
Don't call me Jen.
Why don't you call me Dad instead of Cap, and we'll see what happens.
Everybody in the whole world calls you Cap. Why should I be any different?
Because everybody in the whole world ain't my daughter.
Here you go.
I don't drink Mai Tais.
Don't let the umbrella fool you. I got you Chardonnay. Take after your mother like that. To Maria. Wherever she may be. I sure miss her.
So do I. So what are you doing here?
Like I told you in my letter, I'm retiring. Well, semi-retiring, the odd fishing charter or two, but... Bottom line, Jen, I left San Diego because I wanted me and you to spend whatever time I have left on this mortal coil together.
What do you mean, whatever time you have left?
All of it. The salt spray in my face and the wailing wind in my back. Look, Jen, I'm sorry for a lot of what I've done, like...
Like when I was 12? Leaving me with Gladys, your bartender friend, while you took the charter around Cape Horn?
It was only a year. Wasn't that irresponsible? Well, maybe it was, but... Anyways, I caught the biggest fish ever... Look, Jen, I really just want to talk things out with you. Maybe not right here, maybe not right now, but... But over time. Deal?
Well, not right here and not right now. Let's just say it's on the table.
Fair enough.
Just one other thing.
Shoot.
What letter?
Excuse me. Cap Dalton?
At your service.
I hope so. I want you to take me to that white dolphin here.
Ooh. Maybe pretty hard to find.
I'm prepared to pay $10,000.
Ooh-wee. On the other hand...
No, you can't go through with that.
Why not?
If a white dolphin exists, it's covered by the Marine Mammal Protection Act.
Jed Partee, freelance wildlife television producer. I only want to photograph him, nothing else.
Well, you'll be disturbing the wild pods that we've been studying in the area. You can't do this.
When I get my boat fixed, I can do whatever I want.
Here we go again.
It's your call, Jen, but you can't stand in the way of me making my living.
I guess that's the problem, isn't it, Cap? I've always been in your way. Well, if you go after this white dolphin, that is a fact you can count on.
Kids, they like to be idealistic. It's a real world out there. Now, Mr., when did you want to go?
S.A.P.
In that case, I may need a bit more deposit.
You okay?
Yeah. As Cap said when I was a kid, it can be a tough world sometimes.
I guess Flipper didn't want to stick around for his live bloodworms.
I think he's with the white dolphin.
Oh, Maya, not you too. I've had a bad enough day. There's no such thing as a white dolphin around here.
There was 100 years ago. My grandmother Lucy told me about him. His name was White Lightning.
Maya's big on local legends.
White Lightning used to pilot the fishing boats through the rocky straits around here. Kind of like a friend of the fishermen.
Until one dark and stormy night.
Yes, it was a dark and stormy evening. And he was shot.
Sorry.
Who shot him?
I thought you said he didn't exist.
My father's white dolphin doesn't exist. What happened to your grandmother's?
Sailor on one of the fishing boats was drunk. Just shot White Lightning for nothing, put a bullet right behind his dorsal fin. He sunk beneath the waves. No one saw him again.
Until now?
No, till exactly 1 year later, when he reappeared on another dark and stormy night. Just like before, like he was gonna pilot the same fishing boats through the straits. Except what White Lightning did was pilot the boat right up onto the rocks. It sunk, and everybody, including the guy who shot him, drowned. No one's seen the white dolphin since.
Wow, I'd say that's holding a grudge. Kind of like some people I know.
It's a fascinating fable. Except what my father ran into couldn't be any more than an ordinary run-of-the-mill albino.
Oh, I don't know. That tape was pretty convincing.
The so-called TV producer wasn't. I don't trust him.
Well, at least we agree on something.
I think it's White Lightning. I think he's back.
Come on, Cap.
Jeez! Don't sneak up on me like that.
Sorry.
As soon as I adjust this carburetor, another 10, 15 minutes or so. More like a half hour, but I'll get some peace and quiet.
Okay, I'll be back in 15 minutes with my camera and sound
guy. Say, thanks for fronting the repair work on the hull.
Only comes out of your fee. Don't worry, Cap.
You find me this white dolphin, I'll make you the richest, most famous sea captain since Jacques Cousteau.
Dr. Dalton, I'm glad to see you.
Well, I can't really say the same.
I know, but I want to reassure you. My goals here are much like yours. To discover and to educate. The only thing that separates us is I add a little element of entertainment to the mix. Is a little showbiz so awful?
When it jeopardizes a wild dolphin's way of life, yes.
Well, I'll try to be as unobtrusive as possible.
But what about the hordes of tourists who, as a result of your little TV show, will run roughshod through those pods?
Perhaps that's a question better asked of your father. After all, he drummed up the business. Good day.
Son of a water dog beat.
Can't do the job right if you don't got the right tools. Try the 5/8.
Jen?
Don't call me Jen. Daughter of a water dog geek requesting permission to come aboard.
You need permission to come aboard the Maria D, Jennifer.
Thanks, Dad. I think I will. Especially since you're moored at my dock. I don't have 10,000 bucks. I can't make you any promises of riches and fame, but I'd like to come along, if that's okay.
Why?
Because I'm a scientist. If there really is a white dolphin, I'd like to see it.
So would I. And so would Flipper.
Don't suppose you guys got 10,000 bucks between you, have you?
No, but Flipper is the only one who can take you for sure to the white dolphin. Otherwise, you'd just be guessing.
She's got a point.
Maya, what you're thinking, it's impossible. It can't possibly be him.
Who? Who can't possibly be him?
Well, there's only one way to find out.
I suppose you're right. Can Maya come along?
You guys mind some company?
Why not?
You watch much TV?
Some. News, sports, and documentaries. The rest of it you can keep. What about you?
I don't have a TV anymore.
You're kidding.
Uh-uh. Well, actually, I have one, but it's got a ficus growing through the hole in the screen.
What about electricity? You have electricity? Running water? Indoor plumbing? Any of the various other amenities of the 20th century? There he is. Jed Partee, your producer friend.
What network is he on?
FBI.
Excuse me? You're talking about the guy that Jennifer and your dad just went out to sea with?
The same. And he's wanted on various federal warrants.
For bad producing?
No. Partee's actually a freelance wild animal broker. One of those guys who captures exotic or endangered species for the private collections of rich guys. They keep them in cages and tanks or hunt them down for sport.
What are the outstanding warrants for?
Mostly dealing with illegally transporting lions and tigers and bears. Oh, my. But the ones we need to worry about have to do with the cruelty to humans.
We gotta warn them. And then we gotta get to them.
Maria D, Maria D, Maria D. This is Search and Rescue 1. Listen, Cap. National Weather Service has reported a heavy squall line headed in your direction. Return to Bal Harbor.
What do you think you're doing?
We're taking over the boat. After all, I did pay to get it fixed.
What do you want?
We want to catch ourselves a fish. A white one. Now, all we want is everyone's cooperation, including his. Okay, come on. Come on, let's go.
Thank you.
whole course with him, Cap.
If I hold that course, I'm gonna rip my hull out again.
Don't worry about that. Just follow the dolphin. He'll take us to his friend.
Well, I would worry about it.
Oh, and why's that?
Because White Lightning's gonna lead us up onto a reef. He still wants revenge.
Revenge? On who?
People like you.
Oh, Doctor, I'm deeply hurt, but I'll get over it. White Lightning, huh? Yeah, it's a cute name.
You may think he's cute, but he took 17 sailors to the bottom of the sea.
When?
About 100 years ago.
Yeah, I don't think dolphins quite get to live to 100, but ask your teacher here. I mean, she's the expert.
Maybe this one did.
Just hold the course.
Coast Guard's too far away.
How far away?
Roger. We'll give you exact coordinates as soon as we establish visual contact. Absolutely. Wouldn't dream of it. Roger and out.
Wouldn't dream of what?
Taking these guys on by ourselves before the Coast Guard gunner gets there. I guess I lied.
Yeah, I guess you did too. Thing is, we gotta find them first.
I think I know a good place to start.
Stay with them, Cap! Come on!
That's him. I don't care about you sons of squids, but I'm not risking their life for anything.
I will.
No, don't!
Leave him alone!
Get them inside.
Get him!
Shut up!
There he is!
Get the net ready! Come on!
Of course!
You don't shut up. I'm gonna throw them overboard. You hear me?
It's okay.
Maya.
It's okay, White Lightning. No one's gonna hurt you anymore. Go.
Wait.
I'm sorry.
Don't be. It's better this way. Maybe not for us, but for him.